It's another year, which means it's time for yet another GoPro. GoPro sure didn't leave out any features this year when it comes to the Hero 10. With 5.3K at 60 FPS and 4K at 120, there are literally no boundaries of what you cannot do. The Hero 10 is packaged in the same casing as the Hero 9, which is absolutely perfect. The inclusion of the case just makes the Hero 10 worth even more when it comes to the price. It's worth it to note that for some reason, GoPro makes you update your Hero 10 before you can even use it. The update for me took slightly over 3 minutes to install, plus pairing of the app, which took under 1 minute. Inside the package, we have the USB-C to USB-A type charging plug, a sticky curved adhesive GoPro mount, the GoPro Hero 10 battery, a thumb screw, and a GoPro quick clip. Last but not least, we have the GoPro Hero 10 itself, wrapped in tons of plastic and paper. So satisfying. Time to put the battery and the SD card in and power on this bad boy. The main difference between the Hero 10 and the 9 is the quality jump. Besides that, the GP2 chip increases the overall smoothness of the GoPro. Navigating through the touchscreen is way more responsive and by far less laggy than the 9. As you can see in this test video, the Hero 10 knocks the 9 out of the park in terms of speed and overall smoothness. Besides all these other changes, the front screen also has a frame rate upgrade to 30Hz, instead of before where I think it was 20. The new blue logo and the Hero 10 markings are really the only way to tell that you and do in fact have the Hero 10. The body is the exact same as the 9, which is actually a plus in some ways, as the mount and accessories built for the 9 work just as fine with the 10. In the end, the choice to upgrade in my opinion is simply if you would be able to utilize the higher quality. If you don't tend to use slow-mo and your computer can't handle the 5.3K footage, the GoPro Hero 10 isn't for you. However, if you love slow-mo and your computer can handle the higher quality, by all means, upgrade. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already and let me know in the comments what features I should test and compare down the road. Thank you guys.